Hey everyone, welcome to another Small Adventure Saturday. Today we're turning up the heat by going to lava hot springs. Before we jump into today's adventure, I wanted to say a quick word. This is a pretty new channel, and I'm trying to find my groove with this whole Small Adventure Saturday thing. I want to showcase the places, but I also want to showcase the microbes, and I'm not sure if I'm doing too much of one and not enough of the other. If you've seen some of my other Small Adventure Saturdays, let me know the things that you like about them, and let me know what things that you wish that you would see more of. Do you prefer the small part of Small Adventure Saturday, or the adventure part? Would you like to know more about the areas that I go to and what it's like to vacation there? Or are you just along for the whole ride and you want to see everything? Anyway, let me know in the comments below. Alright, enough of that, let's jump in. My wife and I have been to lava hot springs before, but this time was a little bit different. This was our first time bringing our baby on our travels, and I wanted to make sure that he was safe. That's why Laurel made sure that he was in the car seat instead of my microscope. Archer is 3 months old now, and honestly I was really worried to take him on a vacation, but he didn't do too bad. The only thing is that he wouldn't sleep at night.
We're definitely gonna need a vacation after this vacation, because someone won't let us sleep.
But let me tell you all about the town of Lava Hot Springs. This is a neat town, and despite it being really small, there's quite a lot of things you can do. First, there are the actual hot springs, which are located at the top of the town. This is the hottest water that the town has to offer. There are several different pools, and each have their own temperature range. The river itself is pretty warm as well, and there's things to do like tubing. Lastly, there's a decent-sized water park at the bottom of the town. The water in the water park is really warm as well, but there's also a lot of chlorine in there. So depending on what you're interested in, there's something there for everybody. Once we were all settled, I decided it was time to collect our first sample. So we went straight to the river.
Alright people, this is Archer's first time going microbe hunting. How do you feel, sir? Great! I was speechless my first time too.
The air temperature was about 38 degrees Fahrenheit, but the water was about 67 degrees. I collected a little bit of moss and dirt, and I figured I'd be able to see different things in the different areas. I want to start off this time with the nematodes I found. Normally, nematodes freak me out. I don't know what it is, but just the way that they squirm and wiggle, they're just hard to predict, and they just creep me out. But today was a little bit different. I feel like I was noticing some really interesting behavior with these guys. For example, here's one that was kind of dancing around the substrate, and it looked like it was either cleaning itself or doing something. I couldn't figure it out. Here's another one that looked like it was struggling to eat a diatom. You know, I think I might appreciate these guys more if I just give them a chance. Here was a cool looking rotifer at the very tip of the slide. Next up was a group of ciliates that I found. First I found just one or two, and then eventually I started to see them all over the place. I wanted to see these ciliates do something cool like eat, but I think I got the opposite, and I think this one pooped. Watching the ciliate poop, it kind of made me wonder, are these guys getting anything of nutritional value from eating these diatoms? Diatoms have a very tough shell, so I'm not sure if they're getting any nutrients out of eating these guys. Now the last cool thing in this sample was this midge larva that I found. Now again, I haven't seen midge fly larva until last week, if you've seen my Lake Pleasant video. It's really cool to see the insect larva right next to some ciliates because it kind of gives you a sense of scale of the microscopic world.
The good thing about traveling with a microscope is that you don't have to bring all that stuff home with you. So we're going to go ahead and drop this back off in the river. So long, new friends.
Now, I haven't told you guys this yet, but I actually came here a couple of years ago and I tried to collect water and I got some from the hottest hot spring that was about 112 degrees, but I didn't find anything. And I came home really disappointed, but this time, I wasn't going to quit. I decided to ask the locals if they knew anything about microscopic life in these hot springs, and their answers were pretty illuminating. It turns out that over 2 million gallons flow through these hot springs every day. Fast-moving water is hard for things to grow in, and that's why you'll often find a lot of microbes in stagnant water. Another thing they told me is that the only place where they tend to get microbial growth is on the sides of the pool, where algae can kind of grow. But they scrub these pools every single night to keep them algae-free. Luckily for me, though, they missed a spot. I found some of this algae here, and I collected it by scraping it with my fingernails and putting it in a slide. When I put it under the microscope, however, I didn't really find a lot of living things. There weren't any ciliates, or rotifers, or worms, or nematodes, or anything like that. In fact, it wasn't until I zoomed all the way in to the highest magnification that I have that I was able to find some sort of either bacteria or archaea, very, very small things. Obviously, there's this algae here as well. But this algae is also very small, thin, and filamentous. At these temperatures, not a lot of stuff is able to survive. If they are able to survive, they're what's called an extremophile. So there you have it, lava hot springs. Overall, it was a pretty fun trip. We saw some cool microbes, and Archer allowed us to have a little bit of fun, and I think he enjoyed it himself as well. Anyway, thanks again for watching, and see y'all next time.